Alright, this is the truck I was talking about yesterday in my video. I'm getting ready to clean it up. It's a little rough. He hasn't washed it in a while, so it's going to be a little time consuming. But I'm pretty excited to see what it's going to look like all cleaned up and waxed. I'd say it's never been waxed, so. Alright, so we just got him washed up, did a full hand wash on it, and now it's time to wipe her down. I use this method. I use this rubber thing. It makes life just a little bit easier. I think you can tell, gosh, this thing needs wipes. It's a little rough, it's a little dull. It could use some good cleaning. So after I wipe this off, I will get back with you. And also, here's another thing I like to use. I think it makes life a little bit easier as well. I use a filtered, I use a compressor, but it's got a filter on it. Just to get all the nooks and crannies, the water out of them, makes it a little bit easier. After I do all that, I use a chamois. If I can find it. Where did I put that? Yeah, these windows are absolutely pitch black. It's crazy. I don't know how he sees out of this thing. Here it is. And I'll be showing you a few spots that's getting on my nerves. That's bugging me. I've got to get out. Like this one, right there. So we'll try to get that out for him. After I wipe all this down. And what I use to wash it, we always hand wash our vehicles, is just a bucket, obviously. And I like to use this stuff right here. It's car shampoo from Adams Polishes. It's really, really good. It smells good. And yep. And I've also have a little foamer I like to use. Right here. That's really, really good. It's a little dirty right now, but good stuff. So after I get this all wiped off, I will get back with you. I'm gonna show you how important it is to clay your vehicle. Brand new clay bar. Just purchased it. It's brand new. Nice and clean. Quick wax. I'm gonna show you a little spot. It wasn't as bad as I thought, but you can see here just a little bit of that little section, just some dirt like even right there too. It is important, I think. I keep stressing it too. Clay your vehicle. And for buffing, I use this portal cable electric buffer. It's got variable speeds. I bought it about a year ago. I love it. I've got several buffers, but this is one of my favorite. It seems to do the best job. I'll show you what I use. And a lot of people think that, you know, you need to spend ungodly amount of money on products. Well, that's just not true. I use this stuff. If it's not bad, I'll use this stuff. I mean, it's Meguiar's fine cut cleaner. I love it. And I don't know, some people use the most expensive stuff. It's not the product, it's how you use it. And I think that's just me though. I turned it down to a 3 when I first started. I put a little quick wax down, and then I'll bump it up to a 5. Basically what we're doing is just trying to take the fine scratches out of the vehicle. Not that bad. And then after that, I use like a medium fine cut microfiber cutting pad, just a light cut. And then after that, I'll go over with a little hand polish it. Same step on this side, obviously. That's a little nasty. That's it, fresh clean clay bar. And now it's time to buff. We'll be right back. All right, I'm gonna show you that little spot when I get out.
Right there.
I'll take a little 3,000 to it. It's not bad, it looks service. As you can see, the moisture in the headlights, that's really bugging the hell out of me, so I'm going to take that out real quick. And I just use a heat gun. Don't get it really hot because you will melt the headlight. Got the Chevrolet done. It's looking really, really good. All shiny. Shiny, shiny. We got that spot out. Right there. Clean the bed out for him.